Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to run x64 software on a Raspberry Pi. We'll be achieving this by using a software called Box64. This software works by dynamically recompiling the x64 code into something that your ARM64 device can handle. This dynamic recompiler is key to how Box64 runs so well on a Raspberry Pi. Instead of just blindly converting an x64 call to an ARM64 call, the dynamic recompiler reconfigures things so that it runs more optimally on the ARM64 hardware. Installing Box64 is incredibly simple, and even better, using it to run x64 software is even easier. One thing to make a note of is that Box64 is purely for running x64 software on ARM64. It isn't like Wine, which is a translation layer to run Windows software on your Raspberry Pi, but Box64 can work with Wine. Now, before continuing any further, you will need to be running a 64-bit operating system on your Raspberry Pi. We'll be personally using Raspberry Pi OS, but you can also get away with Ubuntu. To get started, you'll want to open the terminal on your Raspberry Pi. This can either be directly or over SSH. With the terminal open, you'll first want to update your package list by typing in sudo apt update and then pressing enter. Once the update completes, upgrade any out of date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade -y and then pressing enter. With the upgrade complete, we can now move on and install the software we need to compile Box64 on our Raspberry Pi. You can install these packages by typing in sudo apt install git build -essential and then cmake followed by -y. With these packages now installed, we can move on and download the official Box64 code directly to our Raspberry Pi using the git package we just installed. You can clone this repository by typing in git clone https://github.com/ptitSeb/box64.git. Now, if you want to get a stable release, you can specify the specific version you want by typing in --branch followed by the letter V and then the version number, such as 0.3.4. However, for this guide, we'll be removing the branch option and just cloning the latest available code. With that done, we'll now need to change into this directory so that we can compile and install the Box64 software onto our Raspberry Pi. Change into this directory by typing in cd /box64 and then pressing enter. Next, make a directory for the code to be compiled in by typing in mkdir /build and then pressing enter. Once created, we'll then need to change into this directory by typing in cd /build and then pressing enter. We can now get the Box64 code to be configured to compile on our Raspberry Pi. To do this, we need to type in cmake --drpi, all in capital letters, and then the number of your Raspberry Pi. The available options are either 3, 4, or 5. If you're using a Raspberry Pi 5 or 500, you would use the number 5. For those running a Raspberry Pi 4 or 400, you'd use 4. And finally, those running a Raspberry Pi 3, you'll use the number 3. Now after this, type in ARM64, all in uppercase, =1, --dcmake __build_type, all in uppercase, =rel_with_deb_info. Once this is all typed out, press enter to configure for compiling this code on your Raspberry Pi. You can now compile the code by typing in make --j(\OPEN)\(end proc)\), and then pressing enter. The option that we added at the end of this line essentially just ensures that the makes tool will use all available cores of your Raspberry Pi. This will help significantly improve the compilation time of Box64 on your Raspberry Pi. However, please note that this process will take a few minutes to complete still. Once the compilation process is finished, we can easily install Box64 onto our Raspberry Pi by typing in sudo make install and pressing enter. Now, whenever you attempt to run an x64 software on your Raspberry Pi, you'll now be run through Box64. To save you from having to restart your Raspberry Pi for this change to take effect, let's restart the systemd bin format service by typing in sudo systemctl restart space systemd hyphen bin fmt. At this point, you have successfully installed Box64 onto your Raspberry Pi and can now use it to start running x64 software. To give you an example of this, the next few steps will walk through installing and running the Factorio server. This is a good example as the server is available on Linux systems but has only been compiled for x64 systems. Let us now download the Factorio server files by typing in wget://http://factorio.com/get-download/stable/headless/linux64/O/factorio.tar.xz. Once downloaded, extract the archive by typing in tar:x F:factorio.tar.xz and then pressing enter. Once the extraction process finishes, let us now run the Factorio server to generate an empty save. We can do this by typing in /factorio/bin/x64/factorio/--create/home/ followed by our username, which in our case is pi/factorio/saves/my-save.zip. If we freeze the footage for a second, we can see that Box64 is being used to run the Factorio server on our Raspberry Pi. This is a lot of debug information that is more useful for the developer of Box64 than yourself. Now that we have generated a new save, let us run the server using this save. This will give you another indicator of how well Box64 is able to run x64 software on an ARM64 device like our Raspberry Pi. Start up this server by typing in /factorio/bin/x64/factorio/home-start-server/home/followed by your username/factorio/saves/my-save.zip. At this point, we have successfully managed to run an x64 software on our Raspberry Pi. All of this is made achievable thanks to the Box64 software. This is all made quite easy thanks to the hard work of ptitSeb. We'll leave a link to his GitHub below where you can choose to donate to him if you'd like. If you found this guide to be helpful, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.